I recently dove into the concept of finding companies with big safe dividends and identified 18 companies that ranked above the 75th percentile in both BSD score, which stands for Big Safe Dividends, and the Quadrix rating based on Charles Carlson's book, The Little Book of Big Safe Dividends. If you haven't seen that video yet, I'll link it in the comments below. In addition to the metrics derived from the BSD book, I added a few key performance indicators of my own, including 10 years of dividend growth, a 5-year dividend growth rate greater than 10%, and these are all companies that beat the S&P 500 in the last 10 years for total return. And when you see these companies, you will understand that this is me not chasing yield, like at all, you guys, seriously. There's not huge yields, but you'll see what I mean as we roll through these companies. So today, let's check out these companies in a little more detail and make sure you let me know what you think because I can take it, even if you think I'm a little crazy. Oh, and in the end, I'm putting my money where my mouth is. Isn't that such an odd saying? Okay, anyway, let's roll through these companies. We're starting with Lincoln Electric Holdings. The ticker symbol is LECO. They're traded within the industrial sector. And this company was founded back in 1895 and is headquartered out in Cleveland, Ohio. Operating through three segments, Lincoln Electric is in the business of designing, developing, manufacturing, and selling welding, cutting, and brazing products worldwide. They operate 17 manufacturing locations in 20 countries and serve customers in over 160 countries. Currently trading at $193.44 a share, year-to-date you can see they're up in share price by 32.33%. The dividend yield is 1.32%, the annual payout is $2.56 for each share you own, and they've got a nice low payout ratio of 28.95%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 10.29%, and 20 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 269.35%. Next up is Nordson Corporation, and the ticker symbol is NDSN, also traded in the industrial sector. This company was founded in 1909 and is headquartered in Westlake, Ohio. Operating in three segments, Nordson engineers, manufactures, and markets products and systems to dispense, apply, and control adhesives, coatings, polymers, sealants, biomaterials, and other fluids worldwide. Presently trading for $242.29, the Nordson Corporation is up year-to-date in share price by 1.79%. The dividend yield is 1.08%, and right now you're receiving $2.60 for each share that you own. Payout ratio of 26.91%, 5-year dividend growth rate at 16.72%, and 25 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 258.83%. Next up is Microchip Technology. The ticker symbol is MCHP, and they're traded in the information technology sector. This company was incorporated in 1989 and is headquartered in Chandler, Arizona. They develop, manufacture, and sell smart, connected, and secure embedded control solutions in the Americas, Europe, and Asia. Currently trading for $86.62, Microchip Technology is presently up in share price by 25.75%. The forward dividend yield is 1.76%, annual payout of $1.53 per share, payout ratio is only 20.95%, and they've got a 5-year dividend growth rate of 13.56%, 19 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 447.67%. Next up is Analog Devices, and the ticker symbol is ADI. They're also traded in the information technology sector. The company was incorporated in 1965 and is headquartered in Wilmington, Massachusetts. They design, manufacture, test, and market integrated circuit software and subsystems that leverage analog mixed signal and digital signal processing technologies. Presently trading for $185.31, Analog Devices is up in share price by 14.61%. They offer a dividend yield of 1.85%, an annual payout of $3.44 per share, and a 29.92% payout ratio, with a 5-year dividend growth rate of 11.74%, 19 years of dividend growth. The 10-year total return is 383.67%. Pretty familiar to most of us is Microsoft. It's the number 5 company on my list today, and the ticker symbol is MSFT. They're founded in 1975 and headquartered in Redmond, Washington. They develop, license, and support software services, devices, and solutions worldwide. And as someone who uses their products every day, I keep asking myself why I don't own any shares. I think it might be time to dip my toe in the water. Presently trading at $337.22, Microsoft is up in share price by a whopping 40.75%. The dividend yield is 0.8%. They've got an annual payout of $2.72 per share. Payout ratio is only 28.45%. 5-year dividend growth rate at 10.02%, 18 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 1,037.62%. Next up is Graco Incorporated. Ticker symbol is GGG, and they are traded in the industrial sector and incorporated in 1926 and headquartered in Minneapolis, Minnesota. This company designs, manufactures, and markets systems and equipment used to move measure control dispense and spray fluid and powder materials worldwide. Presently trading for $83.57, Graco Incorporated is up in share price year-to-date by 23.08%. With a dividend yield of 1.13% and an annual payout of 94 cents for each share that you own, the payout ratio is at 31.67%. 5-year dividend growth rate of 12%, 17 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 323.06%. Kroger, ticker symbol KR, is traded in the consumer staple sector and operates as a food and drug retailer in the United States. Founded in 1883, it's based in Cincinnati, Ohio. Currently trading for $47.17, Kroger is up in share price year-to-date by 6.34%. With a forward yield of 2.45%, the annual payout for Kroger is $1.16 for each share that you own. Payout ratio at 24.3%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 15.77%, 16 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 200.02%. Next up is Visa. Ticker symbol is V, and they were founded in 1958, headquartered in San Francisco, California, and they operate as a payments technology company worldwide, enabling authorization, clearing, and settlement of payment transactions. Currently trading for $236.45, year-to-date, Visa's up in share price by 14.01%. The dividend yield is 0.75%, annual payout of $1.80 for each share you own, payout ratio of 21.09%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 17.2%, 14 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 436.86%. KLA Corporation is the next company we're going to take a peek at, and they were incorporated in 1975. They're headquartered in Milpitas, California. Not sure if I'm saying that right. This corporation designs, manufactures, and markets process control process enabling and yield management solutions for the semiconductor and related electronics industries worldwide. Currently trading at $455.83 a share, the KLA Corporation is up in share price by 21.05%. The dividend yield is 1.13%, annual payout of $5.20 for each share you own, payout ratio of 19.23%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 15.59%, 13 years of dividend growth, and prepare to fall off your chair because the KLA Corporation has a total return in the last 10 years of 1,114%. We're at the halfway point, so while I take a sip of water and catch my breath, I want to tell you a little bit more about Seeking Alpha. It's the platform that I use to do my daily research and track my investments, and I'll leave a link for you to check it out in the comments below. Next up is the Snap-on Company. Ticker symbol is SNA. Traded in the industrial sector and founded in 1920, it's headquartered in Kenosha, Washington, where they manufacture and market tools, equipment, diagnostics, and repair information, as well as system solutions for professional users worldwide. And I can personally say there may be a few Snap-on tools here in this house. Presently trading at $280.73, Snap-on is up in share price by 22.39%. The dividend yield is 2.3%, the annual payout $6.48 for each share that you own, payout ratio of 34.88%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 14.65%, 13 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 275.16%. Let's talk about Primerica. Ticker symbol is PRI. They're traded in the financial sector, founded in 1927 and headquartered in Duluth, Georgia. They provide financial products to middle-income households in the United States and Canada and operate in 4 different segments. Currently trading for $199.12 a share, Primerica's up in share price year-to-date by 40.29%. The dividend yield is 1.31%, annual payout of $2.60, payout ratio of only 18.66%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 21.67%, 12 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 453.56%. Reliance Steel and Aluminum was founded in 1939, is headquartered in Scottsdale, Arizona, and trades in the materials sector under the ticker symbol RS. They operate as a diversified metal solutions provider in the United States, Canada, and internationally. Currently trading for $275.74, year-to-date they're up in share price by 35.7%. Dividend yield is 1.46%, annual payout of $4 per share, payout ratio of only 13.01%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 14.57%, 12 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 408.03%. Are you guys picking up what I'm putting down here? Do you guys see these total returns? They're pretty impressive, right? And now we've got MasterCard, founded in 1966, ticker symbol is MA, and they're headquartered in Purchase, New York. Another technology company providing transaction processing and other payment-related products and services in the United States and internationally. Trading for $388.68, year-to-date they're up in share price by 12.08%. Dividend yield of only 0.58%, annual payout is $2.28 per share. The payout ratio is 19.83%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 17.8%, and 11 years of dividend growth, with a 10-year total return of 597.76%. Are you guys feeling my big safe dividend picks? I'm kind of digging this. And that brings us to Elevance Health Incorporated. The ticker symbol is ELV, and they were founded in 1944 and are based out of Indianapolis, Indiana. They're a health benefits company, and they operate through four different segments. Presently trading for $429.40, Elevance Health is actually down in share price, might be the first one that we've encountered so far, by 14.5%. They have a dividend yield of 1.35% and annual payout of $5.92 for each share. Payout ratio is 17.58%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 13.74%, 11 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 488.78%. Little Fuse Incorporated was founded in 1927 and is headquartered in Chicago, Illinois, and trades under the ticker symbol LFUS. They manufacture and sell circuit protection, power control, and sensing products in Asia, the Americas, and Europe, and they operate through electronic transportation and industrial segments. Trading for $289.61, Little Fuse is up in share price by 28.53% year-to-date. Offering a 0.84% dividend yield, the annual payout is $2.40 for each share, payout ratio of only 15.01%, a 5-year dividend growth rate of 10.15%, 11 years of dividend growth, a barking dog, and 281.35% total return in the last 10 years. About Steel Dynamics, ticker symbol is STLD, and they were founded in 1993 and headquartered in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Together with its subsidiaries, they operate as a steel producer and metal recycler in the United States through three different segments. Trading for $105.16, Steel Dynamics is up in share price by 9.3% year-to-date. They offer a forward yield of 1.63%, $1.70 for each share that you own, a payout ratio of 7.02%, 7% payout ratio. Take a moment and take that in. 5-year dividend growth rate of 17.44%, 10 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 778.36%. Who doesn't love that? Comfort Systems USA was incorporated in 1996 and is based in Houston, Texas. They provide mechanical and electrical installation and renovation, maintenance, repair, and replacement services for the mechanical and electrical services industry in the United States. Trading for $159.84, Comfort Systems USA is up in share price by 36.5% year-to-date. The dividend yield is 0.5%, annual payout of $0.80 for each share, payout ratio of 10.2%, 5-year dividend growth rate of 16.87%, 10 years of dividend growth, and a 10-year total return of 988.68%. And that leads us to Intuit Incorporated. The ticker symbol is INTU. They were founded in 1983, and they're headquartered in Mountain View, California. They provide financial management and compliance products and services for consumers, small businesses, self-employed and accounting professionals in the United States, Canada, and internationally. Trading for $448.19 year-to-date, they're up in share price by 14.57%. Dividend yield is 0.69%, annual payout of $3.12 for each share, payout ratio of 21.76%, a 5-year dividend growth rate of 14.87%, 10 years of dividend growth, and a total return of 660.92%. And here's the part where I put my money where my mouth is. I'm here in my M1 Finance account where I just created a new pie, aptly titled Big Safe Dividends. It's going to make up 15% of my total M1 account, and it'll contain all 18 of the companies that we just reviewed. And you can see here, I've already added the slices to the pie with the percentage allocation for each of the companies contained within this piece of the pie. I'm set to auto-invest, and so because I invest $200 a week in this account, my investment to the new Big Safe Dividend portion of the pie will be about $120 a month. And my plan moving forward is going to be to periodically check in with you guys and show you how it's performing to see if this type of portfolio will allow us to have big, safe dividends. I can't wait to hear what you guys think, so leave me a comment below and then go and take a peek at this video next. Finding companies that and trades in the material sector, the sector. Is it hot where you guys are? Because I am sweating like a pig. I'm not supposed to be recording. If it's not dogs, it's power tools. Dear me. Mother of heaven above.